Hello, haters. Yes. I just came back from a swing dance. Another new swing dance. It's because I usually work in the weekday evenings, so it's hard for me to go to the swing dance. And there's different swing dances, different days of the week. So today I went to a new swing dance because usually I would work today, but I have the week off for Thanksgiving. So I originally was gonna go, I'll just show you my outfit, then I'll explain. So this hair is just, I put it in a messy bun. This makeup is, I just put on mascara. That's literally it. The cake mascara from Besame. And then these glasses are just my Michael Kors with the sparkles, vintage looking. And then these earrings I got from a vintage store. I will link the haul down below. And then this dress is from Betsy Johnson. I will also link the haul down below. It is extremely cute. I just love this part and I love the print with the butterflies and the colorfulness, and I just think it is so cute. And it's got pockets, which is amazing. And then also, oh yeah, these tights. You can't really tell from this lighting and this far away, but they're black with gold shimmeriness. I got them from American Apparel when I was obsessed with American Apparel. And then I'm just wearing my black Vans. This is very similar to my last outfit of the night / vlog, which I will link down below. Betsy Johnson, American Apparel, a new swing dance, black on black shoesies, classic kind of shoes. And then it was really cold tonight. And so I wore this cardigan that I got from Poshmark. It's supposed to be like a 90s grandpa kind of sweater. And then my purse was just my Betsy Johnson. This one with the lightning bolts. But anyways, I'm gonna have a snack while I explain to you tonight's events, tonight's featured entertainment. I'm gonna shorten the legs of my tripod first. Sorry you can see my room and how junky it is. Oops. Here. And let's go right. Oopsie. Can it go down more? Oh yeah, it can. Cool. So the snack I'm gonna eat Go Macro Bar. Oh, and I drink all my almond milk. So I'll just open up another bottle of champagne. Just kidding. Yeah, right, girl. I'll just open up another bottle of my plant milk. Should get a cup. Oh, okay, here. Ew, I look weird. I think this angle is just bad. Or you're just ugly, girl. But anyways, yes, I'm gonna drink this West Soy Organic Unsweetened Vanilla Soy Milk from Trader Joe's, but they also sell it at Sprouts.
and probably other places too. But this is one that reminds me of like maple syrup and pancakes and waffles and butter.
Yeah, the smell of it. It smells like, remember in the 90s? I don't know if it came back, but in the 90s, there used to be a cereal called Waffle Crisp or Honeycomb. Was it Honeycomb? And it had, I just remember the commercial. It was like this little fuzzy animal, and he was like crazy. He's like, eating the honeycomb. I think it was Honeycomb. Honeycomb Crisp. What did I say in the beginning? Waffle Crisp? Honeycomb Crisp, I think what it was called. But that's what it smells like to me. But anyways, so yes. So this week I have off from teaching. So it's great. It's so great. It's so great. It's so freaking great. I'm so happy we have the week off. Seriously, people, like. But anyways. Not saying I hate my job, but it's nice to have a break, you know. You get to just do your own thing, relax. So anyways, so yeah. So today, what did I do? I slept in. I washed my hair. I took almost a 5-mile walk today, which I love to take walks. You know, especially my neighborhood where I live. I said it before, but there's a lot of plants and trees, and you know, there's always nice weather. We always have nice weather most of the time. And there's just a lot of parks nearby. So I took an extra long walk today to a different park, and I was reading at the park and just enjoying the fresh air and the sunlight and the trees. And then I came home and I ate a lot, which was great. I ate refried beans, and I had some leftover red, like, you know, like dirty rice or Mexican rice from yesterday, and I had leftover like sauteed vegetables and corn, and it was just great. And then some apple juice too. And then after, I was planning on going to the gym to do my push and pull exercises for my upper body, my homework that my trainer gave me, but I don't know if I told you guys. Maybe I did. Yeah, I did. I think in some kind of food hall. But I was like, something happened to my back. I like went into like a mini back spasm, or like I was almost on a back spasm. But my hips were a little bit crooked. So last week I had to kind of take a break from all my physical activities that I usually do. I mean, I still had to teach. That's my job. So, and I only took one ballet class for myself. And it was like shorter, but whatever. Anyways, so this week I wanted to get back into my, like, ease back into my, you know, working out kind of schedule. And I was going to do my homework for my push and pull exercises that my trainer gave me, because I didn't do any at all last week. And also today was going to be a yoga class at my gym. So I was going to do my homework exercises and then take yoga. Cool. That was the plan, girl. And I went there, and I was thinking, since it's the week of Thanksgiving, people are probably already like spending time with their families, or they're feeling lazy because they're getting ready to eat all this food, or, you know, I just thought the gym is going to be more empty. That's what I thought. Like totally the opposite. The gym was so packed, and all my homework exercises, like all the like different kind of weights and equipment that I need for my homework exercises, people were on them. And you know, especially like the weights area is like all guys. It's basically all guys. Like every time I work out with the weights, is basically
I'm the only girl, or maybe there's one other girl in the weights area. But so it's already like intimidating, like, because just for different reasons, you know, if you're a girl, you understand. It's just like, you don't want to be all mixed up in that. And like, usually when I go, there's not that many people there. So there's not that many guys there. So it's less like intimidating, I guess. But like, since it was so packed, all the stuff I needed to use was being used, and there's so many like guys there, I didn't want to be all up in that. So I was like, ugh. So I thought, okay, maybe I'll do my weights after my yoga class. But it was still like an hour until yoga, so I was like, I'll just do whatever, you know, little exercise class is going on before yoga, because there's like Zumba and all these other things. So I'm like, okay, I'll just take a class, do yoga, and then after yoga, it will be later, so maybe less people will be there. Cool. So then I never took this class before. It's called Bozu Boot Camp. You know what a Bozu is? It's like one of those things where it's like flat, and then but it looks like half of a big exercise ball, but it's like half, and it's like plastic and flat, and then the other part is like a exercise ball. You guys know what I'm talking about? Just look up Bozu ball and you'll see it. And I was like, okay, cool. Yeah, sometimes I use the Bozu. Like, I mostly do like try to do unbalancing exercises, like those cool ballerinas do on Instagram, where they're on one leg and they're on demi point and they lift their leg and they turn it behind them and they go like this and do all this crazy stuff to show off their balance. So that's the only way that I've used the Bozu, is like try to be like cool Instagram ballerinas. Side note, I'm not. surprise. Okay, but anyways, yeah, so I still need to work on that, but still. It's honestly, for me, the reason why I do that is so I could, like, at some point film a cool Instagram video of me, like, balancing and doing all this cool stuff. That's, like, the real reason. I mean, of course, to help my balance in ballet. Oh, of course, girl. Yeah, but I really want to do a cool Instagram video like that and have everyone be like, whoa, Michelle is so cool. I had no idea, because she seems like such an idiot and nerdy loser girl. yeah, so, but anyways, I do it for the gram. But anyways, what was I saying? Okay, so I took this class, and the teacher was like this older woman who was like super fit. Okay, people want to say that, you know, younger women who are like really fit and really beautiful and like really healthy and like all peppy and have all this energy and all this stuff, people want to say those people intimidate them. No, girl. No. Older women who are like that are way more intimidating because they're freaking older. So you know it's harder for them because they're older. So the fact that an older woman is more in shape, more peppy, more zippy, more, yeah, guys, that's more intimidating than a younger person. Because a younger person, you kind of expect it. It's like, okay, yeah, they're young, like they still have it in them. But older people, the fact that you can maintain that or get to that point and like still do it is like so intimidating. It was like this older lady, and she was saying, yeah, guys, okay. And plus, when I like tell stories and I imitate people, this is not really how they are. That's just how my interpretation. So basically everyone in my stories sounds like a stupid idiot, like valley girl. Well, that's just because how I talk. It's not, they're not really like that. They're like regular people. Okay, but anyways. The older lady was like, yeah, you guys, I broke my clavicle, so I can't really do a lot. But like, she was doing still the best out of everyone in the whole class. She's like, yeah. She's like, this is basically what she was saying. Yeah, guys, I'm like, you know, like 65 years old, and I have a broken clavicle. But, so I can't really do it as much as you guys can. Cool, she's still doing it better than all of us. But anyway, she was like, this is a high intensity, high impact, quick interval. She was saying all this stuff. And I was like, mind you, I had just eaten a whole can of refried beans, a whole bunch of vegetables, a whole bunch of rice. So I'm kind of still full because I wasn't planning on doing like a lot of like exercising. I was planning on lifting weights, like going like like I wasn't, and then doing yoga. So I wasn't planning on like jumping around and doing all this stuff. So my stomach was still kind of full and I was like, why did I get myself into this? And then there wasn't that many people in the class. There's only like one other girl, like younger girl like me, and she was like, you know, she was more fit, like, and then there was two or three older ladies who were, you know, not so fit, but so it wasn't that many people. And so, oh my god, it was just, I mean, I don't plan on taking that class ever again, but I'm glad I tried it. I was like, why did I do this to myself? And I was like, the instructor was like telling us like, if you're too intimidating, because like basically how we did it is like, oh, this is like the Bozu. So like, this part is like the balancing part, and this is like the squishy part. So basically, first we did it with the squishy part, and you're supposed to like step on the squishy part and step back and jump up and step back and then go to side. Sorry, my boyfriend was calling me, but I'm just gonna call him back. I just declined his call. I'm sorry, boyfriend, if you watch this video, but I'm just on a roll, you feel me? So, but anyways, so, and the lady was like telling us like simpler ways, like, oh, if you're too scared or if that's too hard for you, do it this way. So I was all doing the simple way the whole time. I was like taking my time, and the music was all like, like all fast, and the lady was like, yeah, like, feel the burn. She was like saying all this stuff, and I was like, no. It was so bad. It was so freaking mad. Because probably the other like older ladies were probably looking at me and that younger girl like, oh, they're gonna kick our butts. They're so good. They're like younger. They're like look more healthy. They're probably gonna kick our butts. But I was like, no, girl, I'm with you, girl. Because I was like, fool, I just got over my kind of injury last week. I didn't want to be doing that shit. I thought it was going to be like, I don't know, like more tame. I don't know. But, and it was only half an hour long, so that's good. But it was just like, I mean, I should have guessed. The class is called Bozu Boot Camp. I shouldn't have taken that freaking class. I don't know. But I was sweating, even though I was, like, putting in, like, kind of minimal effort. Like, I just wanted to put enough effort so that the teacher wouldn't yell at me, you feel me? Because she kept on pointing out the other younger girl. She kept on saying, woohoo, this is her first time in class and she's kicking everyone's butt. She, like, kept on saying stuff like that. And I was like, oh, my God. I wanted to be like, girl, I just ate. Girl, I just had an injury last week. Can you stop, like, comparing us to that, you know, to that little, you know, fitness guru or something? Because you know how some girls are just, like, so crazy about the gym. And I honestly think that's kind of, I don't think that's healthy. I think that's part of an eating disorder because that used to be me. Like, I used to be obsessed with the gym. And this is a whole other thing, but people look at people like that, that are all, like, obsessed with the gym as, like, a cool thing, as, like, an aspiration, as something you should be. No. That's not healthy. It's not healthy to be obsessed with exercise like that. I mean, if your profession is, like, a personal trainer or something, I mean, it kind of makes sense. But even personal trainers are not really that crazy because that's their job. So, like, why would you continue to do your job outside of your job that intense? I just think it's not healthy to be obsessed with a gym like that. You feel me? It's not. Don't look up to people like that because I don't think they're healthy. I mean, physically they probably are, but their mentality is like. But anyways. So then I was like sweating, and then after I was gonna take a break, I was gonna go to my car and eat my little snack before yoga because it was still like half an hour. Oh.
But so I walked past the desk and I told the girl that works the desk, I said, oh, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna come back for yoga. And she goes, oh, yoga's canceled today. And I was like, cool, girl. And I was like, what am I gonna do? Cause I was kinda, I think cause I was also like pepped up from the class or something. I was like, oh man. Cause I felt like I wanted to do something. I didn't wanna just come home and watch Netflix and like relax. I didn't want to, cause it was still early in the night and like, I didn't feel like doing that. I was like, man, what can I do? And also I didn't wanna drive too far. You know, I wanted to like do something. So I was trying to think about, okay, what swing dances are on this night, you feel me? And there's a website called Swing Dance LA, and it tells you all the different swing dances on the different nights in the LA area. So, I remember there's a swing dance on this night, so I looked it up, and I was like, cool, I have time to go home and change and go check it out. I mean, it's kind of far, but it's not too far, you know? So, I called my boyfriend. Because he doesn't usually go to the swing dance either, because it's kind of far for him too. But I called my boyfriend, left him a message saying, oh, I'm going to check out this new swing dance. If you want to go, we can meet there. But first I came home, I changed. Then I had to do something at my parents' house. And then my brother and I, we got into a conversation, talking about different stuff. And so, finally, I made my way to the swing dance, and, it's pretty cool, it's pretty cool. Honeycomb cereal, soy milk. But anyways, so I went there, and it's a cool building, it's cool, it has a cool vibe, but this one, not a lot of people go to. It's like that other swing dance I went to the other week. It's like a cool place, a cool vibe, but no one really goes there. So, like, when I walked in, it was kind of empty. I mean, it was a cool place. Like, why doesn't anyone go there? It's a cool place. And then, so, the lady that was doing the desk or whatever, I said, oh, I'm here for the swing dance. And she was like, oh, there's not really people here. And I was like, because when people, this is how I am. When people give me some kind of like indication of like rejection, any little slight little indication of rejection, like it used to be really bad, it used to be so bad, like, when I was eating a lot of sugar and coffee, like too much yin stuff, it used to be so bad. I would pick up on little tiny thing of rejection and it would like destroy me for the night or whatever. I'd like cry and spiral into thinking about all these other things just that would depress me. If I would call somebody on the phone and it would be loud in the background, like I could hear they were busy doing something or they were in a crowded place, but they answered their phone, and I wanted to like talk to them or like see if they wanted to hang out. Already, the fact that it's loud in the background should give me an indication, oh, it's probably not a good time or, you know, whatever. So if I called someone loud in the background and I say like, oh, can you talk or do you want to hang out or something? And they'd be like, oh, I can't talk right now. Oh, I can't hang out right now. I'm busy. I'm somewhere. Whatever. I would take that as like, this is how fucked up my, you know, shit is. I'd be like, oh, they think they're glad they're busy.
They're glad they're somewhere else. They don't want to talk to me, so they're probably thinking like, oh, thank God I'm somewhere so I don't have to talk to Michelle. That's how I would think, people. So like any little thing of rejection, even if it's like just something like that, like they don't really mean to be like I can't talk, like I don't want to talk to you. It's not like that. Like they literally can't talk to me. It's too loud, whatever. I would like switch it around in my brain and just make it worse on myself. So like she was like, the fact that girl was like, oh, no one's really here. I started to feel like that. Like she was telling me, we don't want you here. Go home, girl. No one likes you. Like, that's how I started to feel when she said that. And I was like, I think she saw that I was feeling like that. And she was like, oh, but if you want to stay, you can. And then another girl came up and she's like, oh yeah, a lot of people went home already, but like you can still stay if you want to. And I was like, I was like, I wanted to ask them, so what do you want me to do? Like, I wanted to ask them that. Like, do you want me to go home? Am I not welcome here? Like, is that why you're saying this to me? But like, really, there wasn't really anybody there. there really wasn't. It was like maybe like those two girls and like three other couples like on the dance floor, but it was like a big place. And then Stone. So I was thinking, I was like, well, I drove all this way out here. Might as well just stay. And plus it was only like an hour and a half left of the dance because I was talking to my brother for so long, but I was like, oh, okay, yeah, I'll just stay. And then, so some of the people I already knew, two of the guys I already danced with before. Yeah, two of the guys I already danced with before. One guy was new from out of town. One girl was one of the guys' like wife, so I knew her too. And then the other girls I didn't know. But it turned out to be fun. It turned out to be fun. Like, I'm glad I went. It's a cool place, you know? I mean, the only thing is, like, yeah, there wasn't that many people. But they told me, you know, like, earlier in the night, there's usually more people. And also, you know, it is, like, a holiday week. So probably people are, like, getting ready for Thanksgiving, spending time with their families. So maybe it'll be better another time. But it was still fun. I like that there was not as many people because we got to, like, talk more. And they were really cool. Like, I think this one girl that I met, one of the girls that in the beginning, you know, that was, like, saying, like, oh, you could just stay if you want. She was, like, really cool. She was, like, so nice. And she was, like, I mean, she was a good dancer, and she actually teaches a different style of dance, but she's like new to swing. But I think she's pretty good for anybody, you know, not just being new. But you know, since it was such little people, that the DJ was like taking requests and stuff, so she was playing like a whole bunch of Grease songs, and we were just having fun. We weren't really just doing swing dance; we were doing like, just having fun, you know, just like pretending like we're in the movie, like, you know. So it was nice. And then after they invited me to go to Norm's. If you guys don't know what Norm's is, it's kind of like Denny's, like open 24 hours. It's like a diner. But I was like, I have an appointment tomorrow morning. And plus, I don't want to be spending money. And also, too, I don't want to be... These are new people, you feel me? I just met them. They're cool. They think I'm okay. And if we eat together, I don't want to make a big thing about, like... Because I don't know really what they have at Norm's anymore. I'm sure I could find something, but I didn't want to be, like, all weird. If they think what I eat is weird and they think, like, something about me. I don't know. I just didn't want to be drama too. you know, when it came to food. So I just went home, but it was fun. It was cool. I liked it. So maybe I will go back there again some other time. Even though it is a little bit far. Actually, it's not that far. Because it's very hard. Like, usually on this day of the week, I teach for so long. And I get so tired and stressed out. Like, just drained from all the kids. But if I'm not too tired, maybe sometimes I can go over there. And if I'm, like, off, you know. Like, today I was off, so. But anyways, I'm going to call my boyfriend back. Thanks for watching this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Later, haters.